Hello, Mr.
Hi,
President.
how are you?
It's wonderful to see you.
Well, good to see you.
May I present Jim McCreary,
Hello, Mr.
my
President.
Next Republican congressman from Louisiana to replace Buddy Roman.
Well, I do too, and I certainly appreciate the opportunity to meet you today.
Well, listen, pleased to meet you. We'll do everything we can to help.
Thank you very much.
Right. I think maybe they want us over there in those chairs. So
okay.
Doing some good.
We'll be over here.
All right.
That's terrible.
That's right. Well, I'm from North Louisiana, so maybe it's not too bad. My accent, I could talk like this, like
everybody. Oh, well, we have a few things in common. I too started out as a Democrat. Very active.
Well, that's right.
Very wonderful. I remember. The first being Republican president.
When did you switch?
Well, that's got something to the story. 1962 is the state, the governor's race in California. And they had asked me to stay Democratic. They wanted to see the others because it would be more effective if I was to have more influence. So, but I was.
Okay, let's see. This is, what was this again?
Hi, Gary.
Hi, Mr. President. How are you?
Good
to see you. So, I was trying to come in just a second.
Good group out there.
Well, they're getting ready. I'm going to line them up for you.
Well,
Mr. President, Aida Allen from Glen Burnie.
Hello there. Well, it's nice to see you.
Yes, sir. Aida's husband, Wayne Allen.
Hello there. An honor to meet you, Mr. President.
Eileen Beck of Houston, Texas.
Yes, President.
Margarita Glynn from Burlington, Iowa.
Nice to see you.
Betty Ann Daly of Pottstown, Pennsylvania.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Kathleen DeFiore from Ramsey, New Jersey.
Thank you.
Nice to see you.
Catherine Ewers from Lemon Grove, California.
Southern California,
well.
President. Thank you.
Hope I'll be going there soon.
Yeah.
Betty Glickard of Washington.
It's an honor, Mr. President. Thank you very much.
Nice to have you here.
Marie Teresa Hall from Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Well, hello,
sir.
I think you're the best president
we've ever had. Bless you. Thank you very much.
Dennis Shudaki from Oklahoma City.
Hello there.
How are you doing?
Just fine.
We appreciate all you're doing, President.
Well, thank you.
We sure do.
Teresa Ianora from Eugene, Oregon.
Hello, President. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
Karen Mitchell from Overland Park, Kansas.
Hello there. Nice to see you.
Nice to see you too. Great.
Thank you.
And finally, James Schaefer from Winona, New Jersey.
Mr. President. Thank you for your honor. Well, nice to see you and to have you here. I think I'm supposed to go over there someplace around the middle. He said, well, no one reads the entire caption, but they always begin reading from there.
Thank you. Could you punch in a little bit closer? Maybe if you turn slightly to the side.
Okay.
That's good. Could you turn slightly to the side? There we go. Okay. Squish in.
Squish in.
There.
Squish in.
There we are. Okay. Thank you.
listen, I'm so appreciative of what you all are doing. I don't know whether you heard my telephone call this morning.
We were talking to you.
I heard part of the argument in trying to get the Hyde Amendment and so forth passed. And, you know, when we start talking about constitutional amendments, it's just struck me recently that actually, if we really could get them to interpret things correctly, it's already in the Constitution.
The right to life.
Those are living human beings.
That's.
Then they're entitled to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Mm-hmm. Right. And, the thinking that's all mixed up, isn't it?
What?
The thinking.
Yes, yes it is. You know, now I told them phone call that I got from 24 very prestigious doctors in this country some time ago after things that I said. And they said that I was on very solid ground.
You are. You are.
Is a living human being.
Mm-hmm. You're doing what our founding fathers did. You're bringing us back to God's values. That's what you're doing.
We thank you.
And we thank you very much. Yes.
I just can't resist knowing how you all feel about such things. I received a letter from a widow whose husband was killed in World War II, whose son is now in the military. She had this copy of this and sent this to me. If you don't mind, I'm going to read it to you. This is a translation of a prayer that was found on a young Russian soldier killed in action in 1944. His name was Alexander Zasipa. Hear me, O God. Never in the whole of my lifetime have I spoken to you, but just now I feel like sending you my greetings. You know, from childhood on, they've always told me you are not. I, like a fool, believed them. I've never contemplated your creation, and yet tonight, gazing up out of my shell hole, I marveled at the shimmering stars above me and suddenly knew the cruelty of the lie. Will you, my God, reach your hand out to me, I wonder? But I will tell you, and you will understand, is it not strange that light should come upon me and I see you amid this night of hell? And there's nothing else I have to say. This, though, I'm glad that I've learned to know you. At midnight, we're scheduled to attack. But you are looking on, and I am not afraid. The signal. Well, I guess I must be going. I've been happy with you. This more I want to say. As you well know, the fighting will be cruel, and even tonight I may come knocking at your door. Although I have not been a friend to you before, still, will you let me enter now when I do come? Why, I am crying, O God, my Lord. You see what happens to me. Tonight my eyes were open. Farewell, my God. I'm going, and I'm not likely to come back. Strange, is it not? But death I fear no longer.
Mm-hmm.
I wish I had that from Mr. Gorbachev.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
God bless all of you.
Thank you, Mr. President.
We will.
Thank you. Appreciate what you've done.
Thank you.
All right.